Hey YouTubers, this message is for targeted individuals. You are being called by the Most High God, guys. You are in the Great Tribulation. That is what's happening to you. This is the seventh trumpet. I announced it already. He had me do it. Praise be God that he gave me that honor. And it is the third woe. The kingdom of this world has become the kingdom of our Lord and his Christ. Amen. The seventh trumpet is a transition between the kingdom of this world and the kingdom of God. It sets in motion the wrath of God, the return of Christ, and rescue of his people. You guys have been chosen by God before the foundation of the earth. The elect, the 144,000 from Revelation. The remnant, those tried in the furnace of affliction. Refined and authenticated, you guys have been proved and approved by God. Okay? He told me to tell you that he knows you are fragile and afraid, but to come unto him. Jesus said, not one of you will be plucked out of his hand. You will not be able to resist him, guys. He's irresistible. Trust me, he will use all means and ways to draw you to him. Okay? You're not going to be able to resist this. This call is irrevocable and so you're not going to be able to say no to this. He's called you from the foundation of the earth. So you're called. So stand up and be counted, okay? But don't continue to let these messages fall on deaf ears, guys. You are being called first to the judgment seat, second to the mercy seat. Then you shall receive your rewards, you know, your crown and your assignment and the Holy Spirit. Well, you have to have the Holy Spirit to come to the judgment seat. So you guys need to receive the Holy Spirit, okay? If you don't have it, ask the Lord right where you are. He's promised me that he's right there exactly where every single one of you are falling under my voice. So call out for him and he will do exactly what I just stated because he promised me and I'm promising you that it's him. And he'll prove it when you ask him, okay? So he said, behold, I am, says, he is measuring his temple. Stand up and be counted. Man, get off my screen. Anyway, so he gave me a strong 730, which is a res. It's a cedar tree. All throughout the Bible, it refers to the cedars of Lebanon. We are referred to as the upright as trees in the Bible. So the Lord's a gardener. So the upright are trees, okay? Anyway, so in Latin, the word for cedar is cedrus, which means true cedars. That means you guys have been authenticated. You have been tried in that furnace of affliction. You are pure and you have been tried to prove that you're authentic and that you are true believers in Christ and true followers of Christ, and now he's calling you, okay? So anyway, then he led me on to this, that cedars are pale brown, and it is also an evergreen, so it's year-round. So this tells me that the Lord is calling forward you guys with tan skin color, okay? You guys that are dark-complected, come forward and be counted, and be measured, and be judged, and be given your mercy. And be given your rewards and your assignments, guys. Don't be afraid of him, okay? It's also a call for the mature. Cedar trees are mature trees. You know, when you see them, you can tell that they're majestic and mature. So this tells me it's a call for 40 plus, okay? So anybody that's fallen under the sound of my voice, if you're close to the age of 40, and also people, he told me, from the Mediterranean area. If you know that you're, you know, from, you know, near Lebanon, then you're called to step forward right now, okay? In the Tanakh, Hebrew priests were ordered by Moses to use the bark of a Lebanon cedar to treat leprosy. So you guys are going to be healing and binding up the wounds of the church and of people, okay? We're going to be reforming the church. It's going to be a difficult job, but we're going to do it. You understand? The 144,000 are called to do this job. Also, Solomon procured cedar timber to build the third temple in Jerusalem. So, and in Revelation, it talks about that we are, he that overcomes will be made pillars in the temple of the Jesus is God. Never more to go out. You guys, wow. You know what I'm saying? And the, they always used, like even in the first temple, they used wood, like acacia wood, and they overlaid it with pure gold. That is what we are. So, I mean, like I live on a woodrow. So I even live on a, you know, a street that's named after, you know, wood. You know what I'm saying? So you guys, look around for these signs. Look at your street signs. Look at your, you know, look at the labels on your clothes. I mean, he's giving you signs everywhere, and y'all are not getting it. So just be aware that that's how he does things, you know. Understand, you guys, I am a fellow tribulator, okay, called into the position of Esther, okay? So I'm in the role of Esther in the Bible, and or a star is how he refers to me, a star. Get it? The play on words. He's so cute. Anyway, I am supposed to lead the elect. You have positions also, so you must come forward and receive them. He will cause everything to fall into place like a tapestry by the master himself. We are the elect, the man child. Christ first came himself as a baby. Now we will give birth, and the 144,000 together will be the bring forth the man child. You understand? And God is spirit, so we will be being led by the spirit to reform the church, okay? And make it the church of Jesus Christ. Praise God. Now, there's a curious, obscure figure in the Bible that is seen throughout the Bible, thousands of years apart, that just appears, you know, called Melchizedek. Okay, and Melchizedek means king, and I think Sedek means holy one. Okay, but it means king, both, he was both a king and priest of Salem, which is Shalom. So obviously that was Jesus. The New Testament refers to Jesus as Melchizedek, priest and king, without genealogy, without descent of God. You belong to him. You are without genealogy or descent. Okay, guys? Some of you may have an M. See that? I don't know if my camera can pick it up. See that M? That's Messiah. You got me? You feel me? Okay? You belong to him, trust me. You may, if you don't have it on you, then you have another mark on you that says that you're his. Trust me, he marks his people. I mean with a mark that shows. You may not be able to see it, but it's there. If you're falling under the sound of my voice and listening to this, you are called of God. Ezra 8:33 says, now on the fourth day was the sinner and the silver and the gold, the vessels weighed in the house of our God by the hand of Meremoth, the son of Uriah the priest. And with him was Eleazar, the son of Phinehas, and with them was Jozabad, and the son of Yeshua. Jozabad, when you look it up in Strong, says 10 Israelites. So we are descendants, we are the man child. We are descendants of Christ, you understand? This is, but now we are called Azraelites. Like my new name is Azrael, okay, which means happy, joyous, and vowed to God. You guys are now not Israelites, you are Azraelites. His play on words, get it? Azraelites, Israelites. Anyway, so you're called of God, so you're going to be full of joy, the full joy that comes from God. So it's going to be different than what other people have. And they hate on happy. I promise you. You're going to be hated anyway. So you guys are descendants of Christ himself. This is why the enemy has been after you your whole lives. Is to stop the revelation of Jesus Christ. And it cannot happen without you. We need you. We need you to come aboard and be a part of this. You know, the revelation of Jesus Christ is... The reason why the enemy hates your guts and mine is because it's his destruction. There's two books in the Bible that he hates. That's Genesis and Revelation. Genesis because it tells about his being cursed. And Revelation because it tells about his demise. and we are facilitating the demise of the serpent. Goodbye and good riddance in the name of Yeshua. Christ will have, Christ will have his ecclesia. This is a call to assembly. He will not take no for an answer. It is written, for what door he openeth, no man can shutteth, and what door he shutteth, no man can openeth. He is shutting the door on the false church, which is led by the angel of light, Lucifer. Goodbye, Lucifer. You're going down. Doctrines of demons and doctrines of men. We have to get rid of this junk out of the church. He's not having it, okay? So he needs all of you. And all of you have different talents. And you need to come forward so he can weigh the value of you based on the talent that he's given you. So if you have an aptitude, like for instance, I went to college for journalism. I never did anything with it. I ended up being a software engineer. Look what I'm doing now. I'm in front of a camera delivering news. You know what I mean? So think about your life and think about the things you were drawn to do. That is more than likely the aptitude or the thing that he has given you from the beginning. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, think about those things, because everything in our lives has been a sign from him, every single thing. And you'll see it'll come together like that and you'll go, oh my gosh, he is God. Because it's amazing. So you guys, listen, this, you know, for what door he openeth, no man can shut it. Some of you guys are having doors that are opened. Some of you guys are having cabinets that keep opening. You know, like you'll leave a room and you come back in, it's open. You wake up in the morning, your front door is open. You wake up in the morning and your chain lock is undone and your door is open. You know what I'm saying? It's God. It is Jesus Christ, okay? You understand? He is trying to give you a sign that I have opened a door for you and you cannot shut it. And I'm here to tell you, I've tried to shut this down. He will not let me. So, anyway, you guys don't miss your calling. He's not going to let you miss it. So, and he's irresistible. So turn to him, okay, everybody? If you're targeted and a Christian, you have been isolated and gone through all this, so you may not trust any, and I mean any human, institution, family members, friends, belief systems, so that you will not trust anything on earth except for Christ. You understand? He has separated you unto himself. This way you are separated unto him. Many of you may have smelled burnt hair. This is a funny one. Now you guys are going to say, well, that's weird. Some of you might say it's weird, and then it's going to happen to you and you go, oh my gosh, I'm under a Nazarite vow. Well, Nazareth, I mean, we say Nazareth in English, but the word, I mean, the town is Nazarite. Okay, so a Nazarite vow is you cut your hair and you burn it in a fire and you vow yourself to God, okay? And you guys may not realize that you're under a Nazarite vow. So, like, I burned my hair. I did it myself because, I mean, I was under direct attack and I needed a weapon. And he told me what to do. He said, burn your hair, cut your hair off and burn it. And then don't cut it again until whatever, you see, it's not very long. Anyway, so I did that, man, and I mean immediately. As soon as you say you're under a Nazarite vow, you are under his pinions. You are protected and you are lifted up out of that abyss, immediately raptured, okay? No more playing around with praying and this and that. If you vow yourself to Christ, you are immediately removed from danger. You understand, guys? So if you need to use that as a weapon, you guys do it, okay? Another word for measure is estimate. So he's also valuing you according to your abilities for service in the true third temple, which is made without human hands. In Ezra 2:59, it says, and these were they which went up from Telmelah, which means Mount of Salt, and Telcarsa, which means Mound of Workmanship, of the king. So began building the true church. Oh, sorry. So I wanted to say that to say, Telmelah means Mount of Salt. Okay, we are salt of the earth and light of the world. We're building this temple, okay? without human hands. You guys are a pillar in the temple of God. Okay? And you need to know that, and tell Carson, you guys are called that are workmen, you know, that know how to build churches, that know how to build people, other people up. You're being called right now. You need to come to the Lord, come to the judgment seat, get this all situated with God so that you can get on with the business of instituting the Church of Jesus Christ by the Ruach HaKodesh, the rock. You understand? It's a play on words again. The Ruach, the rock. Okay? And that's what he's referred to in the Bible, the rock, the Ruach. I love him. Anyway, so you will receive the spirit of holiness. That's the Ruach HaKodesh, which will be with you every step, just like he is me. He tells me everything to say and everything to look up, and all these messages are coming to you from him through me. Many of you don't have a father or mother or know your genealogy. That is because you are of Christ. His blood is running through you, and his word also is running through you. Many of you are already seeing letters, numbers, sentences, words, and symbols. Or your eye is being drawn to a symbol or letters or words or what have you. It is him. He is the word. He is the language. He is symbols. He is communication. So he is drawing you to that to let you know that he is there. Okay? And you guys are going to freak out, you know, when you hear this message. Go, oh my gosh, that Christ is here around me. Yes, he is. He is. Christ is speaking to you. First, start by looking up. If you get any numbers, guys, those are Strong's numbers. Look them up in Strong's Concordance. He's speaking to you. He probably, more than likely, is going to be telling you what, you know, things that you need to be doing. So, like, at first, I thought it was all about me. I thought, oh, I'm doing something wrong. This is about me. No, he wanted me to be delivering messages to you guys. So, get out of your own selves. I mean, I had to. I mean, I'm very... you know, not self-centered, but self-absorbed, you know what I mean? I think, oh my God, I'm real self-conscious, you know, and especially about doing something against the Lord because I love him so much. And so, I mean, I was constantly thinking these things he was giving me was about me, and it was about me giving messages to you guys. So I was missing it for a good long minute. So you guys get with the program, okay? Don't be like me and be slow. So he wants you to stop and take heed to these words. You were chosen, so present yourself before the king. Don't be afraid. You're chosen, you're refined, you're pure gold, tried in the furnace of affliction. You are the great tribulators. Anyway, I think we should get shirts that say, I'm a great tribulator. Anyway, I'm dorky, but that's okay. In Revelations, it says, his elect stand with him in pure white raiment because we overcame by the blood of the Lamb and our testimony. So you guys, your testimony is imperative. Get out there, speak to people, find a platform, get on YouTube, get on Facebook, do podcasts, do something. Even if you feel like you're inadequate, or maybe you're a person that says, I don't even know the Bible. I didn't either. I don't know it. The Ruach HaKodesh is telling me what to say. I'm just a mouthpiece and not so good at it sometimes, but I do try. You know what I'm saying? Praise God. So anyways, get out there and tell your testimony to people. It overcomes the enemy. That is how you overcome. You apply the blood of the Lamb and you stand on your testimony of what Christ has done for you. So don't get hung up on your how filthy you are, because we are as filthy rags, the Bible says. Compared to him, he knows our sin and he knows our affliction. He knows our flaws and he knows our pain and he knows our weaknesses and everything. But come to him, for when we are weak, he is strong, says the Bible, you know. In Job 4:17, it says, he moveth his tail like a cedar. The sinews of his stones are wrapped together. So sinews means tendon. And, of course, stones, we know, we're the stones. We're like the stones of the Israelites. You know, there were 12 tribes or stones on the priest's garment. We're the stones for him. But he, and we're cedars too. And we need to be held together. We all need to form some sort of way to communicate with one another. Okay? Y'all need to be getting on my channel. If you know anybody else that is targeted, tell them about this. Because I was sent as a star, a beacon, you know, a person to give you guys information about what he wants done next. You know, he's going to be building like embassy work. You know, he's going to set his government up the way he wants it set up. And we are going to be ruling the entire earth. You understand? That's the way it's going to go down. I don't care if you say, oh, well, you're crazy, lady. I don't care what you think. Because I believe the Bible. And it says that that's what's going to be done. And it's going to be done. And Christ means business. And that's that. 2 Corinthians states, 8:13 states, for I mean not that other men be eased and ye be burdened. He is offering relief and relaxation of your affliction in order for you to be a pillar in the beginning of the building of the Lord's temple. You understand? This is a great work. He's asking you to be the foundation of the temple built without hands, the temple built by the Ruach HaKodesh. Okay? So step up. Do what you need to do to get right with God. Get on with it. Get over it. Get on with your assignment. And let's get this thing going. You know what I'm saying? I mean, the enemy has had a full, run of this earth for 5,000 years. You know what I'm saying? The Lord is sick of it. He's taking back his possession. And we are the first of his possession. So, and we belong to him, period. Nehemiah 6:15 says, So the wall was finished in the 25th day of the month of Elul in 52 days. Okay, the meaning of wall in this verse in Hebrew is to join, a wall of protection. We need to join to one another and bring others in our affliction on board to build the wall around New Jerusalem. Okay, we are New Jerusalem. And I recommend you guys that may not understand this, but we are not bound by the Gregorian calendar. Like today is what, the 18th of April? No, it's not. That's not God's calendar. We are on a Zadok priest calendar. That means we are Zadok, as in Melchizedek. We're unto him. We're priests unto him. So we're on the Zadok priest, Enoch Zadok priest calendar. And I recommend Nick Vanderlaan on, and you spell it V-A-N-D-E-L-A-A-N, Nick Vanderlaan. He has the correct calendar. The Lord told me to recommend him. You guys go over to his channel, and because he's doing the work of a scribe, okay? So the Lord's called people to be scribes, to be teachers, to be judges, to be, you know, all sorts of positions. So we're all getting in line and beginning the foundation of his church, okay? So be involved and be encouraged. Go over to there and get the Enoch Zadok priest calendar so you know what day it is. And what, you know what I'm saying? So you know how to, and if you don't observe the Sabbath, do it. It's serious, okay? You keep those Ten Commandments. You preach those Ten Commandments because Jesus preached them and teached them and kept them, okay? Very important. Lastly, he gave Isaiah 35:3-4. Strengthen ye the weak hands and confirm the feeble knees. Say to them that are of fearful heart, be strong, fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, even God with recompense, and he will save you. So he is saving us, the elect, delivering us, raising us to be of service directly to him. He needs you to help build his church, guys. Answer the call.